An ideal Otto cycle that uses air as the working fluid has a thermal efficiency of 40% and a compression ratio of 8.5. Before compression, the helium is at 92 kilopascals and 310 Kelvin. If 900 kilojoules per kilogram of heat are transferred to the air during the constant volume heat addition process, what is the mean effective pressure for the cycle? As always, pause here and try solving this yourself before watching the solution. This is the third example for the Otto Cycle main lecture. The link to that 10-minute lecture and the links to all the other lectures of the thermo course are found in the description below. You might have noticed that the concept of mean effective pressure was not covered in the main lecture video. The reason for this is that the term is pretty self-explanatory. Since the specific boundary work of a system of constant pressure can be calculated as the pressure times delta V, and this can also be used for systems where the pressure increases or decreases linearly by using the average pressure, what this term is looking for is that effective average pressure. So if W net is this average pressure times delta V, this MEP value is equal to W net over V1 minus V2, or V4 minus V3. It doesn't matter which, since V1 and V4 are the same, just like V2 and V3 are. Since none of these terms were part of the information of the problem, we'll have to find their values ourselves. From the efficiency expression, W net is eta times Qn. And since the problem gave us both, we have W net. For specific volume at 1, and since air can be assumed to be an ideal gas, we can use the ideal gas equation. We look up the gas constant for air, and substitute the given values for T1 and P1 to find V1. And finally, we need V2. Since the compression ratio is V1 over V2, V2 is V1 over the compression ratio. We evaluate to find V2. We substitute all three values we just found, and we find the value for the mean effective pressure for the cycle. And that's it. Since the cycle fluctuates between a low and a high volume, it's not four distinct volumes, one at each stage, this MEP is effectively the average pressure that would result in a boundary work equal to the net work out. If you want to check out other Otto cycle examples, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermo course, as well as other engineering courses playlists. Thanks for watching!